Good day. You know, I've been following the Mary Mary reality show for the past 4 or 5 seasons. And in this latest season, my spirit has been in disagreement with many of the situations on this show. Even though I love their music and like the ladies, still a great deal, my once naive impression of gospel artists and preachers have been shattered by having watched both Preachers of LA and Mary Mary. It is expected that people are human beings and as such they have faults. It is understood that no one is perfect. However, if you're a role model and leader in the Christian gospel arena, you should probably not have a reality show if you have serious character flaws and some immoral behaviors. Erica Campbell and Tina Campbell are two distinct human beings, and where Erica sacrifices and gives selflessly to her sister, the favor is not returned by Tina. Tina Campbell, as Erica Campbell's former manager Kenneth Kerr rightly puts it, is a bully and very selfish. Erica also has her faults as well, but this season her sister is a glaring example of what not to do. Erica's character has changed this season since launching as a solo artist. Some entitlement and pride has gotten into her bonnet. Tina, however, is being selfish, unforgiving, lying, demanding, unfair, and disregarding the feelings and well-being of others for whatever she wants and however she wants things to go. The blatant example this season is telling the Library of Congress, where they were just inducted, that they definitely have an album coming out in 2016. Lying outright twice. Tina, being Tina, also categorically refused to help her sister by doing a show for her because she was wiped out from doing her gigs and the group's gigs. Erica Campbell even nearly passed out on stage. Tina Campbell takes no time to consider how her actions will affect the relationship between Warren Campbell, Erica's husband and Mary Mary's producer, and the Sony executives. Her whims changes with her ever-changing emotions. The metamorphosis she claims to have gone through has been for the worse and not the better. She might have forgotten her husband Teddy for his infidelities, plural, multiple, seemingly times infinity. Now that is another example of blatant sins. But her character has deprecated drastically. I have not touched on the issue and going-ons with their former manager, Mitchell Solaric. The scenes which included the fights and vile arguments with him and about his management of the group makes me cringe. How he treated the group's stylist and sister Gugu. His behavior at Tina's second wedding and goading Erica was reminiscent of how it must have looked for the snake tempting Eve in the Garden of Eden. Tina inviting him to the wedding was more an act of spite against her sister than anything about being forgiven. If it was a gimmick for the show, the choice to do so is even worse. God is going to call every celebrity gospel artist and preacher to a day of reckoning, and those who repent and change will learn and find favor and grace with God. But those who continue to flaunt their sinful nature and not represent Christ and Christianity truthfully will fall. Many will continue to gain earthly favor, but they will have a reserved place in hell. I will pray earnestly for these two sisters, and I have compassion in my outlook of them, but I do not condone or support them erring and representing Christians in the manner in which it is being done now. I pray they will check these episodes when they air and be convicted in Jesus' name by what they see. The behaviors that are being exhibited has certainly put me off the show, but I will continue watching because I pray that Jesus Christ will change them from the inside out. And all this sinful, prideful, entitled, faux Christian behavior will cease from their lives. Be it so, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.